have Mr. JOSS Fernandez, one of the prominent citizens of the Anglo-Indian community. I request Mr. JOSS to say a few words of English. Please welcome Mr. JOSS Fernandez.
Your Excellency, Governor of Kanada, and Mrs. Excellency, Governor Simpson, the beautiful wife. I bring you greetings, my dear friends, not only to appreciate the fact that His Excellency and the wife have given us the privilege and honor of being here this evening, but also to greet what, in my personal opinion, and perhaps in the opinion of many people, is a community who has the most beautiful girls, only match their husbands, either boyfriend or equally handsome. I think you should cheer that. Most beautiful girls and most handsome guys in India. The Anglo-Indian community. But I think His Excellency and his wife beat us at this very game. I bring you the greetings of the Anglo-Indian Guild. We are completing 30 years in 3 days, on the 5th of August. And we have to express our gratitude to the government of Karnataka for the tremendous help they've given us in the shape of a 100% free reimbursement scheme which took effect from 1987, plus reservations in technical colleges, in technical institutions and colleges. These factors have contributed in no small measure to the growth, the progress, and let us say the prosperity of the Anglo-Indian community in Karnataka. I don't think any other state in India has these privileges. And I think I take this opportunity to thank the government of Karnataka on your behalf and mine for this remarkable and tremendous assistance they've given us over the years. And I think for our country who has the word Indian attached to our name. I think we can be mighty proud of the fact that we're Indians first, then Anglo-Indians. The Anglo-Indian community, I think everyone, as the Excellency would agree, are basically an honest community with tremendous integrity and absolutely no hangouts whenever the negative aspects are concerned. Unfortunately, the community has not been very politically oriented. Now, to my knowledge, there's no power without political power. And I would like to pass this question across to all of you. Please, get into politics. That's where you can change the lives of people. That's where you can protect the telling image of the Anglo-Indian community, and that's where your progress lies. No progress without political progress. We are also happy that in Bangalore there are about 4 or 5 associations. I believe that competition is a healthy virtue, shall we say. And I would like to suggest, if this is a reasonably good opportunity, that we have a federation and request His Excellency to be our patron. I think that should be helpful to the community in general and to all the leaders in particular, and perhaps develop more leadership in the community. There's only one request I think we should make to His Excellency, if he can help us. What we need is a community center, not only for the Anglo-Indian Guild, but for all the association, so that I think we are the only people who don't have one. Maybe His Excellency will help us in that respect. We have made a representation to the Chief Minister, and I would like to invite a few of the leaders. We will make an appointment with His Excellency the Governor, meet him, and explain to him in more close fashion what the need of the community actually is. I think there's no community like the Anglo-Indian community have contributed to the development of the country. teachers and nurses. One cradle from the cradle, and the other avoids you getting into the grave. In other words, the development of the teaching profession and the nursing profession have always been the exclusive prerogative of the academic community. Many of the people who have led this country were educated by Anglo-Indian teachers, and many of those with higher up names, powerful people, have also been nursed by our nursing fraternity. And I would like to suggest now, from mere teaching and nursing, we get into something more important, something higher. Like instead of nursing, let's become doctors. And instead of teaching, let's become headmasters or headmistresses. We have Anglo-Indian schools in Bangalore, I think about 40 of them, who have contributed in no small measure to the development of the community, not only the Anglo-Indian community, but all communities in this state. And I also want to mention about the lovely girls we have, only matched by the handsome guys. I don't think any other community can support this. I hope His Excellency appreciates that. In that respect, I would say, he is one who can beat us for a very game. And as before I conclude, I would say it's a great honor for me to be here to address you. And my only request.